Today we will see the shells of gastropod as a part of your first practical. As you know, gastropod is Animalia, it is Mollusca. Animalia means it is animal in a large group of organisms. Mollusca means the shell is without any skeletal part, rather it is having skeleton outside its body in the form of shell. That is the shell we are going to study. And this is called as gastropoda, means gastro means related the organs related with the gastric system or digestive system. Poda means the appendage or legs. So above the legs are the digestive system parts of the animal. That's why it is called as gastropoda. You might have seen this shell. This is called as cypria in gastropoda. You might have played it for playing some fun games. It uses it as a dice, isn't it? You remember it in the vacations or in childhood, you might have used it for playing purpose. So this is cypria, the known shell to you. Also, you might have collected a few gastropod shells like this in your childhood. Might be there in your personal collection, like this. Many beautiful shapes and sizes, isn't it? These are the shells. You can see the real animal. This is the fossilized shell. This is different from the rest of these three. This is fossilized shell. This is the real shell of the living animal. This is fossilized. You can see that it is petrified. It is turned in the form of a rock. So the original shell is made up of calcium carbonate. Now it is turned into the fossil form. This is called as petrified animal or fossil animal. So this is a petrified part. This is a real fossil. So today we'll be studying a few varieties of shells, like you are seeing in front of you. First is Voluta. The name of this shell is Voluta. As you know, the body parts are taught in the theory class. You can see the shell is beautiful white shell with strength, toughness, so it acts as a protective cover. Okay, now see it from all sides. It's a beautifully nature carved or designed shell by the nature. So animal lives inside this cavity. The animal goes inside to this cavity. So soft body parts are present inside this cavity. So this is the window or door for this animal's house. We call it as shell. So through this window, this animal which lives inside interacts with the outer world, in the surrounding world. So this is called as an opening of the shell, or it is also called as an aperture, as the technical term you know. So this is aperture of the shell. You know, this is the upper pointing end, we call it as apex. Opposite side to apex is the base. So this is base, this is apex. Shell is pointing towards the base. A volute form or a type of cone type structure. Okay. So this is apex, this is base. This is aperture. This is one coil of the shell is called as whorl. You can see if I move my finger along this. See, if I move my finger along this coiling. See, can you see this? This is coiling. If I move along this, let's see where it ends. See, it's going up and up and up and up towards apex. I am moving my finger from the pointed edges of this shell. You can see my finger is moving up to the apex. So this is why it is moving, because of coiling. Can you see it is coiling like this? This is called a spiral coiling. Another coiling will be there, which will be in the plane, one planar coiling like this. But this coiling is not one planar, it coils like this. Okay, this is called a spiral coiling. So this is spirally coiled shell. This is also called as univalve shell. That means all shell is a unit. If you decoil it or if you open the coil, it will form a conical shape, cone shape like this. It will form a cone shaped shell if you uncoil this. But if it is a coiled, spiral coiled, it appears like this. Okay. So one coil, this is one coil. One coil is called as whorl. There is one single coil, there is another coil, there is another coil, there is another coil. So one complete rotation 360, let's start from this up to this, it is called as one whorl. Okay. So between two whorls there is line of junction. This line of junction you can see, it's called as suture line. Suture. So line of junction between two whorls is suture. So if I move my finger along suture also, this gap between the holes, again it moves up spirally. Obviously, as the shell is coiled spirally, suture also runs spirally along the coiled shell. Okay, so there is no one separate suture like this. It is a continuity of the same line of junction. So if you want to ask me how many suture lines are there, practically speaking, it is generally a single suture line which runs spirally. But for our convenience, we say that from this end, the coiling starts, and up to this end, again, one 360 rotation of coil completes spirally. We say this as one whorl. And again, the junction starts here for the second whorl. Can you see? There is no suture line here. It's open end. But when it starts joining with the upper whorl, you can see it forms a suture line. So we can say that there is suture line between this one coil, right? So this is suture line, which is again, we say that spirally arranged. So this is the larger whorl, we can say, towards the base as compared to the other whorls. You can see these whorls or coils are smaller in diameter, and the lower whorl is larger in diameter. You can see diameter, larger whorl, large diameter. Inner whorl is small diameter, again small diameter. So diameter goes on decreasing if you check. So larger diameter whorl towards the base of the shell is called as body whorl. It's called body whorl because soft body parts of the animal lives here, accommodated here in this whorl. Okay, that's why it is called as body whorl, right? So rest of the holes except the body whorl, except this part of the whorl, rest of the holes is called as spire, S-P-I-R-E, as you have seen in the theory. Except the last body whorl towards the base, it is called as a spire. Okay, so spire is a set of holes except the body whorl. So let's check how many holes are there in the spire. This is one whorl, this is second whorl, this is third whorl and fourth whorl. So there are four holes in a spire. So spire is starting from this suture line to this. So this suture line to this is the spire. Can you check? 1, 2, 3 and 4 holes are there in the spire except the body whorl. So total 5 holes are there, you can see. So lower part is body whorl and the rest of them is called a spire. So simple it is. Just you have to remember the terminologies. Okay, body whorl, other whorls which form the spire, line of junction between the holes is suture line, opening of the internal cavity is nothing but aperture. As you know, apertures are of two types. One aperture, as you can see here, is having some discontinuity at the base. Can you see here? It forms a tube-like. Can you see tube? Tube-like ending here. So if you see from this side, run your finger along the margins of the aperture, it cuts here. It is not continuous. But if you see this shell like this, you can see continuous aperture. You see, this is called as holostomatous, complete margin, continuous margin aperture, holostomatous aperture. However, this is not continuous margin. It forms a tube at the base. Continuity of a line of margin cuts here. Gap is there. Okay. So this is called as tube or siphonous canal. Siphonous canal means what? It is a tube-like structure at the base of the shell through which water is sucked inside. So through the water, the animal gets the oxygen and the food. So this is the tube through which the water is sucked inside by the animal. So this is the mechanism of siphoning. Siphoning means sucking. You drink the cold drinks using the straw. The sucking process of cold drink through the straw by using straw is called as siphoning in technical terms. Okay, we commonly say that it's sucking. So siphoning is nothing but the sucking surrounding water through this tube-like structure formed at the base of the aperture, at the base of the shell. So this is siphonostomatous, forming a siphon at the base. Siphonostomatous aperture. This is holostomatous aperture. This is another example of siphonostomata. Can you see tube forming a siphonostomatous aperture? This is also siphon. Can you see tube here? Aperture is not continuous. It is cut here. It is cut here. It is not continuous. So it is siphonostomatous aperture. So siphonostomatous aperture. Another body part is margins of the aperture. The outer margin of the aperture is called as outer lip, because main body part is here towards this side. So this is called as inner side, this is called as outer side. This is called outer margin of the aperture, that is called as also lip. This is outer lip. And this is inner margin is of the aperture is called as inner lip. Okay. Can you see this? So it appears that some inner smooth part is turned outside. Can you see? This smooth part, this is a rough ornamented part. This inner part has come out. So this way it says that this lip, which is inner lip, this outer lip, this inner lip, which shows internal smooth margin, smooth surface outside also, it's called as reflected inner lip. So inner lip is thick and reflected out, while outer lip is thin and is not reflected. It is thin. Okay. Now, if you draw two lines from opposite sides of the spire, it forms an angle here. Okay. Draw lines opposite each other. Draw line touching the outer surface of the shell from this side and opposite side. It intersects here. It forms an angle. It is called as an apex angle. Apex angle are of two types. One is acute and other is obtuse. This is acute. This is acute apex angle. Okay. This is more acute apex angle. Can you see? More acute. If you touch two lines opposite here, it forms more acute angle. Like this. You draw a line like here and draw a line here, it forms an apex angle. So this angle is acute apex angle. So if you draw lines here like this and like this, so it forms obtuse. This obtuse apex angle. So draw lines opposite from on the surface of the shell from the opposite side. It forms an angle of intersection that is called as apex angle, and this angle is obtuse angle. So this is also obtuse angle, not acute angle. This is also obtuse angle of apex. Obtuse apex angle, right? So apart from that, we have here some ornamentations or designs on the shell. Maybe it is done for the production function in the nature. You can see here spines like ornamentation or textured surface. So these spines, you can see here, runs all along the coiling If I move my fingers along the spines, you can see it goes towards the center apex. So ornamentations are also arranged along the coiling or along the holes, runs along the holes. So this is spine type of ornamentation. Okay. Now here, you can see here elevations like this here, running along the length. It is called as ribs. Can you see here? Elevations here, this. These are called as ribs. And crossing to the ribs are here concentric lines. Can you see? This is curved shell like this. And you can see concentric lines. Concentric lines. This is striae. These are the striae, S-T-R-I-A-E, striae. And cutting to the striae are the elevated parts forming ridges. So these are the ridges and concentric striae. So striae, ridge, spines are the types of ornamentations. Where the ornamentation like spines are not prominent, you can see just the elevated part, not prominent spines. They are called as knobs. This is prominent spine. Can you see? Prominent spine. But this is not prominent spine. This is a blunt. These are called as knobs. Knobs. If smaller than knobs are there, you can say it is a granule. Very smaller spots like elevations, then it can be called as granules. But granules are not here in this shell. So the age of this shell, that is, we call it Holuta, name of the shell is Holuta, is Cenozoic to recent. To understand what is Cenozoic, we are here a time scale. Mainly it is a recent part of the geological time scale. It starts with the older age, oldest age here. As you know, the earth is aged at 4.6 billion years. And here you can see time scale divided into so many smaller time periods. Okay, so this is geological time scale. Largest section or division of the time, geological time, is called Eon. Eon is subdivided into era. Eras are subdivided into periods. Periods are subdivided into epochs. And these are the figures which are mentioned in millions of years. What is meaning of million? Thousand thousands is equal to 1 million. Okay. And then at the right hand column, you can see that what are the major lives which were appearing from the older age to the modern age. Okay. So this line indicates a datum line, or the line below which we do not find any fossil records, and above this line we find that life has started appearing on the earth. So this is the datum line, you can see that. Below this line is called as a pre-Cambrian period, which counts to 1.5 billion years or 1500 million years. And we don't have any actual record of fossils here, except few very rarest forms of animals we are here. So using this chart, we can find the age of this Holuta, fossil Holuta. It says that it is from the late Cretaceous to Cenozoic period. Okay, so this is a wide range of time scale where we can see that this appeared on the earth. So what is the latest, what is the oldest period with this appeared on the earth is when the dinosaurs were becoming extinct on the earth. Okay, so up to the Cretaceous, we can see that dinosaurs were present, and up to the Cretaceous period, they became extinct, and animals like this started appearing on the ocean water. So latest age is recent age. It can be found today also in the ocean water. And first they have appeared on the earth is 65 million years. Okay, so this is as old as like the dinosaurs. So dinosaur became extinct on the earth and these animals appear. So 65 million years up to the recent age is the range of these animals. So they are still living. So this is the shell of a living animal, representing still it is there in the ocean, enjoying the life in ocean. But it is said that due to some fishing and environmental issues and global warming, the population of this is decreasing. The shell is tough and used for some ornamental purpose and decoration purpose. For that also it is 100, because it pays the price for people. People sell this shell for decorative purpose. So that is another reason why it is becoming extinct. So mainly it is marine animal found along with the fishing process and becoming endangered species. So this is about Foluta. Next will be a Turritella. This is just, you have seen the shell Turritella here. And for your purpose, I'll be showing it in the maximum light. You can see that this is a shell called Voluta. Okay, body hole, aperture, siphonostomatous aperture, gap here, outer lip, inner lip, okay, body hole, last hole. Rest of them forms a spire. In spire, how many holes are there? 1, 2, 3, 4 holes, WHORLs, holes are there. This is the aperture. It is slit-like, long aperture, as long as the length of the body hole. Outer lip is thin, inner lip is thick. This inner part appears to be come out, forming reflected inner lip. Aperture is at the right-hand side of the observer. So that's why it is called as dextral coiling. So it starts coiling like this, coils like this. So it is coiling like this. If I rotate it like this, it is a clockwise movement. It coils like this. So if I move a finger, it coils clockwise. It's called as dextral coiling. Spines runs along the suture, along the coiling. Radiating elevations, ribs, and concentric striae. Okay, we'll go for the next shell, that is Turritella. Turritella is a elongated shell, as you can see the shape is different here. Here spire is short. Can you compare here? This is last body hole. It is not as big as this shell. But if you compare the length of spire, it is longer. Here spire is short. Okay? Short distance spire. Here spire is long. How many holes it is having? Let's check. So except this last body hole, this is large body hole. We'll check 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11 holes are there in a spire. So except last body hole, we have 11 holes in a spire. So this much part is called a spire. Lower part is called a body hole. Body hole is having larger diameter. Now you can recognize what is this. This is aperture. This is outer lip. This is inner lip. Aperture is continuous, having continuous margin. So it is holostomatous aperture. This is suture line. Can you see? A line of junction between two holes is suture line. If you draw a line joining opposite margins, it forms a acute apex angle. If you join it together, line meets here, forming intersection angle. Angle of intersection, that is acute apex angle. This apex of the shell, this is base of the shell. Ornamentation is in the form of just ridge. Can you see here? Elevated part on the hole. A ridge which runs along the coiling of the shell. A ridge runs along the coiling of the shell. Can you see here? Elevated part here. This is ridge. Okay. The edge of this Turritella shell is late Jurassic. Can you see here? This is the second time period of the geologic time scale, and this is Jurassic. Okay, so lifetime of this record is divided into three sub time zones or time eras, like Paleozoic, Mesozoic and Cenozoic. Paleozoic means primitive life, Mesozoic means moderately evolved life, and Cenozoic means highly evolved life. So this belongs to this shell appeared first in the late Jurassic. That is means the life on the earth was in the middle phase of evolution, and in that Mesozoic, Jurassic was the period when you know that dinosaurs were dominant. The dinosaurs and first birds, early birds like Archaeopteryx, have appeared. So these animals were living along with the dinosaurs. It started appearing on the earth when dinosaurs were there. So probably there is some data of a genetic character about knowledge of dinosaurs animals might be carrying in their gene, okay? Memories of that dinosaurs. Well, anyways, it is 160 million years old time to recent time. That means these shells are found still, these animals are found still in the ocean water. So that means it started appearing 160 million years ago when dinosaurs were there dominant on the earth. So these animals were enjoying their life in the water. Okay, ocean water mainly, saline water. And up to the recent time, means they are still found in the waters. So Jurassic of Mesozoic era up to Cenozoic era, that means recent time, that means current time is going on. We can say that modern man is there and we are studying it already. So the late Jurassic to recent is the age of this Turritella. Last fossil to study in gastropod is this Conus. You can see here Conus. See now clearly. The shape itself says that it's conical in shape. The name is given Conus because its shape is conical. Okay. Can you see conical like a carrot? It is a beautiful shell, isn't it? Orange colored. You might have seen this is white colored shell. This is mixed color, brown and orange color. This is pure orange color. So design, colors, ornamentations, you can see here smooth shell, this is ornamented shell. So ornamentations are different, then designs are different, colors are different. Maybe some nature has had some purpose to give them this variation in the course of evolution. So this shell is a Conus. You can see it is a conical shaped shell, very large body whorl covering. Now if this is the length of the shell, from base to apex, it is called the length of the shell. It covers almost 90%. Last body whorl is very large if you compare the total length of the shell. So largest body whorl is there. It is covering almost 90% of the total length of the shell. Can you see total length here? And it is covering this much, means almost 90% of the total length. So very large body whorl, very small spire. Sutures are not very prominent. The lines are there, but there is no wide gap between it. As you can see here clearly, a gap, very prominent suture line. We don't have here prominent suture line. Suture line is definitely there, junction between two holes. Can you see here? This suture line. If I move my finger along this suture, again it goes spirally, ends up into the central part. Can you see? It is going towards the center, towards the apex. So this shell is also spirally coiled shell. So this is univalve gastropod shell, spiral coiled, having conical shape, having very large body whorl, and length of the spire, that is from except the last hole, this hole to this hole, length is very short. So spire length is very short, length of spire spire is very short. Apex angle, you can see join two fingers at the opposite margins, it forms a obtuse apex angle. So apex angle is obtuse. Okay, so this is aperture. As long as the length of body whorl, it is slit like very narrow aperture. Outer margin of aperture is outer lip. This is thick. Can you see? It is thick, straight or slightly curved. Inner lip. Okay, this inner lip, aperture is, as you know, siphonostomatous, forming a siphon or tube at the base, and shell is smooth. There is no many particular ornamentation. This is it: apex, base, body whorl, slit-like aperture as long as body whorl, very large body whorl, aperture is siphonostomatous, outer lip is thick, this is inner lip, spire is short, apex angle is obtuse, no ornamentation, color is orange, shell is calcareous, nothing more. Its age is Eocene to recent. Again, you are seeing the time scale. Now find out, where can you see Eocene? This is Eocene. That means this shell appeared here in Eocene. That is 54 million years ago. It appeared first on the earth. And still it is there. This shell is still enjoying life in ocean water. So all today's shells, you have seen these three. That is Voluta, Duritella, and now this Conus. All are marine snails or shells of the snail. So this is Eocene to recent. So 54 million years ago this started appearing on the earth first. So Eocene is the epoch, smaller fragment of time period. Which is the period? Period is tertiary. In tertiary period, epoch name Eocene. So in Eocene epoch of tertiary period of Cenozoic era of Phanerozoic eon age, or simply you can remember as it is from Eocene to recent. Eocene to recent. Okay. So which were the other animals present along with this animal? You can see here large running mammals like horse, zebra, cheetah. Those animals started appearing here. Were dominant on the earth. They are also still living on the earth. So whatever animals appeared here, almost they are still living. Okay. And this is also not exception.